Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're at Depoe Bay, Oregon, learning how to fish out of a kayak at the 2014 Oregon Rockfish Classic, a tournament where the winner can not only win a new kayak, but also qualify to fish the Hobie Fishing Worlds Tournament in Amsterdam. Now stay tuned.
I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television.
It's a wonderfully calm summer morning at Depoe Bay on the Central Oregon coast, and today the kayakers have invaded the parking lot for the 2014 Oregon Rockfish Classic, which has well over 100 anglers all getting their required safety check and Coast Guard certification to make sure they're safe as they head out for a day of fishing out of Depoe Bay. We couldn't ask for better conditions as we make our way out of Depoe Bay and into the big water to hunt for big rockfish. Michael Reichner is a former Rockfish Classic champion and one of the directors of the tournament.
What we're doing now is we're heading outside of Depoe Bay, heading south, just within a mile outside of Depoe Bay are a number of different reefs. We're heading to the South Reef right now, and I don't know if you can see this on the screen, but we're basically heading out. I've got some spots already marked. These are some really good rock systems and upcroppings of rock that there's always a lot of big fish on. So we're going to kind of get out here, explore this a little bit, and see what we can find. So today, because we're doing the Oregon Rockfish Classic, which is a heaviest fish tournament, we're looking to get the biggest, heaviest fish we can. So what we're targeting today is ling cod and cabazon. Which are all over below us. Basically, we're on top of them at this point, but we're just going to keep heading down here, cut a little bit south, and we should be on them in just a second. So basically, we're now coming up on that south reef that I was just telling you about. As you can see, we're coming out through the fog. We got a few other anglers here that obviously know about this spot. So basically, right now, I'm at about 50 feet of water. I got a really aggressive shelf or a reef right below me right now. We're gonna continue cutting over just this way a little bit more and get on a little bit more of the bumpy side of this reef, the big rocky side. So we're coming up on it right now. So basically we're gonna go ahead and begin our rock fishing quest here. I'm using a 4-ounce jig head Lancer jig. Gonna go with one of my favorite Procure scents is the sardine gel. Very good for out here in the rock fishing part of the coast here, big rocky pieces. The best thing I can do is get it as close into a seam as possible. I'm also using the gel, which is going to help hold position inside of that crack and actually put out scent for quite a while. That's all I gotta do right there. We are straight on top of this reef, and I was just marking some fish down there, so let's go ahead and see what this is gonna pull up. Now this jig is imitating a squid. A wounded squid, because it's going to be bouncing on the bottom, and or octopus. We find both of these animals in their stomachs when we clean these fish, so we know that's a really big part of their diet. That's why I'm using this white pattern and starting with this. Very easy to see. It's nice right now. We don't have a whole lot of current going on, so we're basically just going straight up and down. These fish will hit this jig as it's moving up and as it falls. Obviously never when it's just sitting there. So a very, very strong thrust, a good pump up.
Nice.
Looks like he's got a little size to him. We'll see what we got. Looks like a cabazon. You don't feel nearly the head shakes or the big, there we go. Maybe I'm wrong. Whoa, there he goes. He's not coming up yet. Ooh, he doesn't want to come up. There we go, come on. Definitely feels like a cabazon, but let's find out. Here he comes.
is a caddy.
Not a tournament winner, but a nice cabazon at that. There he goes. Look at the size of these pectoral fins. Those are like water breaks as you're pulling these fish up. Those just create the most resistance. So they feel like really big, big fish. And they are. That's probably a, I know it doesn't look like it, but that's probably a 9-pound cabazon right there. So wonderful fish. Very, very good tasting fish. Most of the diet of these cabazon is crab, so they also call this the poor man's lobster of the Northwest. Not big teeth like a ling, so I'm gonna go ahead and just use my hands, get this out as quick as possible. Because it's not a game winner, I'm gonna go ahead and release it, let it grow to be a game winner in a couple of years. So we just passed over a nice contour line where we went from about a 30 foot to 45 feet deep. A lot of times these ling cod, big lings and cabazon like to hang out right on that bottom of that drop off and wait for food to either drift off and fall down to them or whatnot. So we're gonna target some fish right here.
Welcome back to the 2014 Oregon Rockfish Classic Kayak Fishing Tournament out of Depoe Bay, Oregon. I'm Justin Wolf. Michael Reicher is a former champion, and today he's fishing hard to try to win that trip to Amsterdam.
Most of your hits, I'd say about 80% of the hits are actually on the fall when that jig's coming right back to the rocks. Ooh, just missed one there. So I'm gonna go ahead and switch things up here. I started out with a white kind of colored jig, which is gonna imitate more of a squid or octopus. Now I'm moving over to just a blue with a green eyes. I don't know really what fish this imitates, but it's a very successful color and shape for cabazon. So we'll see what we can find. And I'm actually looking at quite a few fish down below me, so maybe we can pick one up here. Got a fish over there? Not a bad fish there, but I don't know if I've got him hooked. The way he's coming up feels like I've just barely, he's on the rubber behind the, nah, he could be hooked. Let's see. Oh, there he goes. There he goes, stripping line right, but that is probably a cabazon. He just changed his mind. He went straight back down to the rocks. So again, my goal right now is to keep him from finding a crack to swim into, and it looks like I've done that. So it definitely feels like a cabazon. All right, we're up to my top shot. And, no, it's actually a ling. But it looks like what's happened is my hook has hooked it in the gill. So it felt much bigger and it wasn't giving off a lot of fight. Not a bad ling, would make some good fish tacos. That is a legal size, I could keep it, but we'll go ahead and release that. Let that one get a little bigger. What's nice about this is at this point we're basically just, we're riding the drift. So we're actually putting this in front of a lot of different fish by just, you know, at this point we're drifting at about a half mile an hour. So that's just perfect. It smells like a small ling. I'm just gonna leave it down there because he's going nuts right now. And I feel like I've got him hooked pretty good. So he's going right back down to the bottom and he's gonna be bait for a bigger fish. Let's see if we can get this to work. I'm just gonna kind of drift him right above the rocks. Remember, I don't wanna let him into the rocks, but I wanna get him as close to the rocks as I can where those big lings are. Now that already feels like there could be a hitch. No, maybe not. We'll let that back down. I'm gonna let him back down. It's a good size. I'll pull him up so you can take a look at him, but that's a great size ling right there to send back down for a bigger one. Let's do that. Let's see if we can find something down there. We'll let this fish do all the work. Basically, he's going to pull us right down into the zone above the rocks so that we can basically put him in view for the big lings. All right, so he's back down on the bottom. So I'm going to just kind of pull him up above the rocks. Let him do the work. Looks like he's coming, but
All right, we'll head back down.
That happens. Oh, but he's back on. Look at that. Oh, that might have been just a snag. There we go. Get him up to the surface and see what we got here. Look at that. He just spit up an octa, a squid right there. Because if I could grab that, I would. That would be great to tip my hook with. Not a bad size ling. Definitely not a game winner, but boy, good tasting fish right there. Again, I'm going to go ahead and release this because it's not the fish I'm looking for. I'll try to do it as nice as I can. I'm going to go ahead and use a lip gripper there. There we go. See you later.
It's a good one. Might get us in there. Yeah, he's eating well. Big old squid in there.
Yeah, so I'm doing a little different is I just keep moving real slow. I put this down. I got a 6 ounce trout grub running around, I don't know, 40, 50 feet, but just kind of keep it moving real slow and just waiting for the rod tip to slam down. So seems to be working right now.
Everyone seems to be catching some fish and having a fun time at this year's Oregon Rockfish Classic out of Depoe Bay, Oregon. Most of the over 100 anglers are vertically jigging with a variety of plastic or metal lures covered with scents such as Procure Super Gel. There are many rockfish species, but for a big fish, everyone is hoping for either cabezon or lingcod, which both live around the many scattered underwater reefs and rock piles in the Depoe Bay area.
A lot of big lings and cabbies hiding in these rocks waiting. Oh, there he goes. Oh yeah. There we go. Let's see what we can do with this. Looks like a pretty decent sized fish. Cabezon. This is part of the tournament today, but that's not the fish I'm quite looking for, although it's got quite a bit more size than the one we saw earlier. Again, a very cool looking fish. Northwest cabezon. Very pretty fish.
By 2 o'clock, everyone has to be off the water and weighed in, with the awards and a big fish fry scheduled for a few hours later. There are lots of good-sized, good-eating fish coming to the scale, but only one can be a winner. Michael has brought in his largest cabezon of the day.
Yeah. Is it obvious?
Michael, I've known you for a long time, buddy.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Oh, great fish. Looks like it weighs in 12 pounds, 9.4 ounces.
Nice work.
That's a beautiful cabezon, but it's going to take a little more than 12 pounds to win the kayak and trip to Amsterdam. That's a better cabezon at 15 pounds, but probably it's just another addition to the fish fry.
So we're back in our fish cleaning station here in Depoe Bay, just getting ready to clean up our fish. This is what I brought in to contribute to tonight's fish fry. So as soon as I get these cleaned up and filleted out, they're gonna head back to camp and be part of a fish taco feed.
At a nearby local campground, it's a beautiful evening for an award ceremony. But first, we have lots of fresh rockfish to eat, and these guys know how to cook it. And of course, on the Oregon coast, oyster on the half shell are a must. After everyone has had plenty to eat and drink, it's time to give away all of the prizes to the top 10 fishermen, plus a raffle. But first, a word from one of the tournament sponsors, Phil Perron from Procure Bait Saints.
And it's kind of frustrating because we didn't get much fishing in. We saw people catching fish and where they're going like, but guys are rolling up, they're just going like, yeah, we're catching them on Salmon Slammer, that bloody tuna works really well. And one of the things that makes Procure so different from other companies is we're fishermen. Myself, my vice president, we're avid fishermen, we're all over the world fishing all the time. And we really appreciate the kayak market. I think it's a way to get guys that were stuck on the bank watching other people in big, fancy, expensive boats on the water. I think there's a joy to the quietness, almost like rowing a drift boat rather than tearing up and down a river in a sled. When I first started guiding in Oregon in 78, you hardly saw a sled on the river. It was all drift boats, guys with muscles and no stomachs. And all those guys got 300 horsepower motors now, and they have pot bellies, and they can't see their feet, and they're guides. it changed, but you guys are out there, you know, in those little kayaks, and it's really cool because you're so in touch with where you are. You're just right there. It's so exciting. And as a market, we realize, you know, we've got guys pictured in Louisiana. We have a guy who sent us a 65-pound rooster fish out of a kayak out of Costa Rica. That guy who's listed out, you don't need sand. He put some buddy tuna on and nailed that big rooster fish. So now the guy's using their stuff. And that's what it's all about. I think Pro Cure grows more by word of mouth. We don't have a real big advertising budget. It grows by word of mouth because it works. For some of you guys, you know about it. For some of you guys maybe coming in from Florida, Louisiana, might not know about it. I hope you got some samples. And spread the word, you know, ProCure works. We make all of our scent. It's real bait, it's not artificial. If you come to ProCure, you'll see two 40-foot freezers packed full of mullet and sardines and squid and shrimp and sand shrimp and mole crab. I mean, we got it all. Thank you for letting us participate, and we'll be supportive of you guys. If you've ever seen the ProCure logo, it's got the pirate. And he's got cross swords. We're working on one for kayaks right now. It'll be a decal, and it'll be available, I think, within the next 2 months. And it's going to have cross paddles.
Woohoo! Nice.
Nice. All right, thanks, guys.
Hey, I hope you're enjoying today's episode. Now, before we go back to the Oregon Rockfish Classic, here's Josh Cooper, the rod designer at Lamiglas, with some ideas on how to choose a rod for kayak fishing.
Here at Lamiglas, we build literally hundreds of different kinds of rods. But today we're going to talk about kayak fishing and selecting a rod for kayak fishing. About 6 years ago, we set out to build a series of kayak rods, and what we found is that what people wanted in a kayak rod was as diverse as the fish that they fish for. So there's a lot of different things to look for, and a lot of it comes down to personal preference. Some people prefer a longer butt so that they can stick it up under their arm while fishing with a little bit longer foregrip and for fighting fish. Other people prefer a little bit shorter butt, a more traditional style rod that they can stick it in their hip like they would if they were in a standard boat. So when trying to build that series, we learned that really it was, we made the rods already for what people wanted. We just had to steer them in the right direction. And so there's two things that I would really pay attention to when selecting a kayak rod. And the first one would be a tether. So this is something you can add on, very important. I prefer not to fish with one attached while I'm fishing, but I like to have it there so that I can attach it and set it in the boat while I'm not fishing. But the other thing, the big thing is composite. I prefer a composite tip, and I think I consider it a must. While fishing from a kayak, just because of the angles involved in landing fish. So you need a lot of power in the butt, and some people like to be able to go up, out and around the front of the kayak. So sometimes that little extra added length will help, and that stiffness in the butt will allow you to do that. But the big thing is when you do that, you create a hinge point in the tip. And you can have that hinge point as long as there's a material that will handle that. And a composite or a graphite and fiberglass blended rod will typically handle that a little bit better. You can also high stick fish. In other words, when you get a fish close to the boat, that's a must for kayak fishing. So when you get a fish close to the boat, you're going to have that tip straight up in the air. And by doing that, you create a hinge point on a standard rod, something that a composite rod handles a lot better than an all graphite rod.
Thanks, Josh. Now let's find out who won
the 2014 Oregon Rockfish Classic. Is Kenneth Dickens with a ling cod weighing 19 pounds, 14 ounces. Let's hear it for Kenneth Dickens. Very good.
That's huge. Congratulations.
You know,
I just gotta say, it's about time somebody besides Michael or John won this thing.
I started paddling out there and I saw these three big waves coming through the chute and I thought, what did I get myself into today? But after I got out there, I went beyond the Whistler buoy and turned north a little bit. And between the swells and everything, we weren't getting many bites. And then I thought I had snagged up on the bottom, but it wasn't the bottom. My pole just kind of bent down and the line just kept stripping off. And it was kind of exciting. You know, I never caught a ling this big before. And got him up there and got him in the boat, but he was as long as my leg. And I couldn't control him hardly. He flipped out on the left side of the boat one time and I got him back in. Finally got the gaff into subduing when, you know, before I could use my fish subduer on him. And then I couldn't lift him. And I was using a Trident Prowler and I could not get him into my center hatch. And so I knew I was kind of in trouble there. So I probably lost about an ounce of fish trying to beat his head down through the hatch. And this is a 4 foot long hatch, you realize. And then I just had it in, kind of excited, just hoping I'd place in the top 10 even.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.